One of the oldest tricks in the Shotshell Reloader's book is loading by weight. Although somewhat contentious in modern literature, this reloading method remains a very popular way to design new loads where no other data exists. The folks who employ this technique reason that whether you're loading birdshot, buckshot, or slugs, an ounce of lead is an ounce of lead and should behave the same. While this may be a convenient way to look at things, and if we're being completely honest here, I've done it myself many times before, the fact is, physics aren't quite that simple. The volume, shape, and fluidity of a projectile all play a role in determining pressure, the importance of which can't be overstated, as shotguns can fail just like any other firearm. With the practice being as widely used as it is, I decided to do some experimentation to see just how much ballistics change when substituting different projectiles by weight, and hopefully establish some basic safety guidelines. Before we go any further, I want to make two things very clear. Number one, I am not a professional ballistician by trade. What I am is an average person with the ability to think, research, and reason using the equipment and resources available to me. Number two, while I will post my findings at the end of this video, and you're certainly welcome to use them, ultimately it's up to you to decide whether they're reasonable, correct, and safe to follow. With that out of the way, let's talk a bit about shot shell chamber pressures. Every gauge and size of shot shell has a maximum pressure. For these tests, we'll be working with 2¾-inch 12-gauge hulls, the maximum pressure for which is 11,500 psi, as per SAMI. Now that we know our theoretical maximum, let's begin the experiment. For this test, I've loaded four sets of shells using birdshot data. The first two sets consist of straight-walled federal hulls, 10 with birdshot and 10 with slugs. In order to keep everything as close as possible, I've determined the slugs weigh 1.16 ounces and weighed my birdshot out to match. The remaining two sets of shells were built from taper-walled Winchester hulls. Again, each with 1.16 ounces of either slug or shot. With everything assembled, let's head to the range and see how their chamber pressures measure up. Beginning with the straight-walled federal shells, the average pressure reading was 8,374 psi. Moving on to the matching slugs, the average pressure dropped to 7,532 psi. Let's try the taper-walled Winchester shells next. Starting with the birdshot shells, the average chamber pressure was 8,327 psi. Switching over to the taper-walled slugs, the system indicated an average pressure of 7,227 psi. Let's take a look at those results. With the straight-walled federal shells, there was a difference of 842 psi, representing a reduction in pressure of about 10%. For the taper-walled Winchester shells, we got an even larger difference as the pressure dropped by 1100 psi, or about 13%. Now, many of you are probably scratching your heads and saying, so pressures went down, ergo these loads were safer, so what's the harm in substituting? The reason I chose to use birdshot data for this experiment is that I already knew going from shot to slugs generally tends to lower pressure rather than raise it. Now let's look at it in reverse. What if I'd used slug data and substituted birdshot as my projectile instead? Those pressures would actually have increased, substantially, I might add. The federal shells would have seen an increase of 11%, while the Winchesters would have actually topped 15. Now imagine this had been a high pressure slug load to begin with, say 10,000 psi. Both loads would have been skating the very edge of max pressure. Factor standard deviations into that equation, and you potentially just crossed the threshold. So can you safely load shot shells by weight? The answer is generally yes, so long as you exercise some common sense. There are five simple rules I live by when it comes to modifying load data. Rule number one, substituting projectiles alters pressure. We've already proven this to be the case, so the first thing you need to do when loading by weight is accept this is a fact and needs to be accounted for. Rule number two, select load data with wiggle room. This means staying away from high pressure loads. We've already seen two examples where pressure changed by up to 15%. When selecting load data to substitute, I generally aim for 8,500 psi max, leaving me a buffer of about 35%. Rule number three, allow for standard deviation. Just because your average pressure is just under the max doesn't mean every shell loaded is going to stay there. Rule number four, alter as few components as possible. If you're already changing the projectile, don't compound things further by substituting wads, primers, or hulls. Every change you make introduces another unknown value to the equation and serves to further complicate things. And finally, rule number 5. Verify your shot shell loads with the best equipment you can access. If you're one of my American viewers, lucky you. There's a number of different companies in your country who will happily test shot shell loads for only a few bucks a pop. I can't stress enough what an incredible resource that is to have at your disposal. You guys are spoiled. Outside of the United States, if you're really serious about developing your own shot shells, I'd strongly encourage you to invest in a chamber pressure system and a chronograph. I use an RSI Pressure Trace 2 in conjunction with a number of other tools and methods for establishing pressure, and I found it to be invaluable. Regardless of what methods or equipment you use, the bottom line is this. Substituting projectiles in shot shells can have a major impact on chamber pressure. If you're gonna do it, do it carefully and at your own risk.